This is the SV08, Soval's open-source, clipper-based Core XY 3D printer with a generously large build volume. There's some good, and there's some bad, and we're going to get a look at it right after this. I'm Brian, and you are watching BV3D. Hello, 3D printing friends, and welcome back. So, this is Soval's SV08. Thanks to Soval for sending this over for review. I'll share what I've learned from my time with the printer, we'll take a look at some prints, and I'll go over what I like and what I don't like about it. But first, let's get into the SV08's specs and features. The printer is mostly built of aluminum extrusions, though it does have an injection molded plastic base. It's got a large build volume of 350mm on X and Y and 345mm on Z. It's using a Core XY motion system, and it's got linear rails for the X, Y, and Z axes. The X and Y component is a flying gantry system, meaning the bed stays firmly rooted at the bottom of the printer, and all the X and Y motion components move upward as the print progresses. There are four independent Z axis motors, and it uses a quad gantry leveling process in which the printer probes all four corners of the bed. It automatically adjusts each corner of the gantry to make sure the corners are at a consistent level relative to the bed. The printer uses an inductive probe sampling a 9x9 grid, mapping the high and low spots to help ensure a good first layer. And it automatically calibrates the Z offset value. But you can still adjust this during a print if you need the nozzle a little closer or farther from the bed on that first layer. Speaking of the bed, it's an AC mains powered bed that can reach 100 degrees Celsius, and it has a magnetic spring steel sheet with a textured coating on one side. The tool head has a direct drive extruder with a planetary gear drive to push filament through a 0.4mm nozzle that can reach 300 degrees Celsius. The spool holder is in the middle of the right side at the top, so you're not having to reach around the back of the printer to load filament. And it has a filament runout sensor, so it can let you know, in its own subtle way, when you need to run out and get more. It comes with a flash drive that contains the manual as a PDF file, Mac and Windows versions of the Orca Slicer software, and a pre-sliced file or two. You also get the usual assortment of tools. Assembly time is about an hour or so. It's not difficult, it just takes some time. Walk-up control is provided by a small backlit monochrome display and a knob. This lets you access basic functions like preheating the printer, loading or unloading filament, controlling fan speed, and starting, pausing, or canceling a print. You can also connect the printer to a wired Ethernet network or a Wi-Fi network and interact with it from its clipper/mainsail web interface. This gives you more detailed information about the printer's status, allows you to control the printer, and also lets you live monitor its onboard camera. And the printer is open source. They've got the hardware and the software stuff up on GitHub if you want to poke around. So that's pretty much it for the features. Hey, if you're getting value from this video, a subscribe would mean a lot to me. That lets me know I'm making content you enjoy and you want to see more like it. Thanks! Now let me share some things I've noticed while using the SV08. The screen and knob control panel here is basic, but it gets the job done. It'll show the nozzle and bed temperatures along with other status information. Clicking the button gets you into the menu system where you can preheat the printer, load and unload filament, handle a few setup tasks, and select files to print. One thing I've noticed about it is sometimes when you click the button, it'll select the menu item just above or just below the one you were on when you clicked. Other times, it just won't register the click at all. I don't know if it's just this specific screen or if they're all a little bit flaky like that. Getting the printer on a Wi-Fi network is a little bit of a clunky process. I get why it's that way, though. Can you imagine trying to enter a Wi-Fi password on this screen? So instead, while you're at your computer, create a plain text file that contains your Wi-Fi network's name and password. Plug the printer's flash drive into your computer and copy that file to it. Then, plug the flash drive into the printer, pick the Show IP Address menu item, and wait a few seconds. The printer reads the file and then uses the information to connect to your Wi-Fi network. With the printer on the network, either wired or wireless, you can connect to its IP address in your web browser to interact with it. You can also add it to Orca Slicer so you can slice and print directly from the slicer instead of having to save the G-code file to your desktop and upload it in the browser, or having to save the G-code file to the flash drive and walk it over to the printer. The filament runout sensor works, but it's kind of subtle. Running out of filament triggers a printer pause, so the printer parks the tool head at the front left corner. It keeps the bed and the nozzle hot, but it doesn't beep or otherwise do anything to get your attention. You just have to notice that the printer isn't moving anymore. When you walk over to find out why, you'll see that it's out of filament. Then you can unload what's left in the Bowden tube and load some more and resume the print. One last thing I want to mention when it comes to using this printer is the noise level. It's loud overall when it's printing, and that's to be expected when printing fast. There's going to be motor noise, and there's going to be fan noise from the part's cooling blowers. The faster the printer can cool a layer down, the sooner it can start printing the next layer, and the less time the printer takes to finish the job. I get that, and I get that blowers aren't quiet when they need to move that much air. But that doesn't need to be the case for the mainboard's cooling fan. It's obnoxiously loud. Maybe it wouldn't be so annoying if the mainboard's cooling fan didn't run constantly, but it does, so it is. Why can't you hear it on the video? Because I couldn't stand it, and I did something about it. But that's a topic for a different episode. Okay, now it's time for print show and tell, and these are all printed in PLA. So while I've also put more than a kilogram of TPU through this machine, those prints are for a different video. A video with a lot of soul. First, here's the pre-sliced Vinci that came on the flash drive with the printer. It took about 19 minutes from the time I started it to the time it was done, so that includes printer warm-up time. Actual printing time was probably more like about 14 minutes. I don't see any major problems with it. I think it's a pretty good Vinci for the speed. Heck, it's just a pretty good Vinci. Next, I have a Calidragon from designer MacGyver. This printed in about 21 minutes. There's a tiny bit of stringing, but it's minimal. The surface quality is really good, and the backs of the antlers don't show any cooling issues, and I think it came out great. Here's a fidget cube from designer LaForest Labs. It printed in just under an hour and a half. It's a fun little print. It has print-in-place hinges, and though some of the links were initially a bit tight, they loosened up after a little while. So all the hinges work like they should, and you can fold this cube over and over on itself forever. Now, here's Aria the Dragon, designed by Luby3D. I scaled this up to the full build height of the SV08, so you can see how tall the printer can print. It took 5.5 hours. The result is pretty good, but there is some stringing between the wings. You could take care of that with a heat gun in a hot minute. Although really it would probably only take a hot 15 seconds or so. The stringing is partly a result of the printer profiles having Z-hop enabled. So whenever the printer has to move the tool head from one part of the model to another, like from one wing to another, it raises the nozzle a little bit, moves, and then lowers the nozzle again. And that can contribute to stringing. So printing this model without Z-hop enabled does a great job of eliminating the stringing. But it does increase the chance of the nozzle tripping on the print and knocking it over and then making a beautiful plate of spaghetti. Poor Aria. This one doesn't have stringing issues, but the failure did clip her wings. Then I wanted to print a trash can. No, I wanted to print something fancier. And I found this one. It's the Sand Dune Plant Pot by Sassy Design. And you can tell from the name, it's actually intended to be a small planter, not a trash can. But I figured I could scale it up a bit and it would work. So I went to almost 200% size, which got me this. And at that size, it took a little over 16 hours to print. I thought I had enough filament, but my calculations were off just a bit. So when I ran out of white, I switched to a gold silk color. That gives my can of trash a touch of class. I also designed an insert to go inside to hold the trash bag, which in this house means reusing a plastic grocery bag. That way the bag doesn't have to hang over the edges, hiding my golden accident. I mean golden accent. For a fancy trash can, it'll do nicely. And I think that about does it for the Prince. So let's go over the things I like and don't like about the SV08, starting with the things I like. Assembling the printer, while a bit time-consuming, is actually pretty easy. The large build volume is nice. You should be able to easily fit single-piece helmets and other large models on this printer. The LED lighting is a nice touch. It's not a huge light strip, but it seems to provide more than enough light so you can keep an eye on what the printer's doing. I like being able to control and monitor the printer from a web browser as well as from Orca Slicer. And I like being able to send print jobs directly from Orca Slicer as well. Finally, the time-lapse feature is nice and it works pretty well too. Now, here's what I don't like. The control knob on the screen can be a little flaky. Sometimes it selects the menu item above or below the one that was highlighted when you pressed the knob. Other times it doesn't register a click at all. Also, the bottom of the toolhead cover, the blue thing with the parts cooling blower built into it, is very close to the level of the nozzle. There's not a lot of clearance between it and the print. That increases the possibility of the toolhead snagging on a print if part of the model curls up a little bit during a print. And when that happens, the magnetically attached toolhead cover can experience something rude that is a rapid, unexpected detachment event. The printer can't detect when that happens and it'll continue printing. It's happened to me twice already. That sort of thing can cause a print to fail, or it can damage the fan's wires, or it can damage the fan's power socket on the toolhead circuit board. And last, the noise level. I think this printer's louder than it needed to be. So that's the Sovol SV08. Thanks again to Sovol for sending this over for review, and there's a link in the description if you want to check it out. Thank you for watching, and a big thanks to everyone who supports the channel, whether with channel memberships or by using the links in the description. If you liked this episode, give it a thumbs up, and maybe subscribe so you don't miss new ones. Well, 3D printing friends, that's about all the time we have for this one, and now that we're at the end, let's go print something cool. The spool holder is in the middle of the right side at the top, so you're not having to reach around the back, so you're not having. Enunciate, Brian. You can do it.